Greetings to fellow Fright Fiends, and thanks for dropping by the Horror Zone. I hope everyone's doing well. Happy Friday the 13th to everyone. This is the second Friday the 13th video I've done this week. Of course, the first one being a breakdown of my top 13 episodes of the Friday the 13th TV series that aired in the late 80s when I was a teenager. That, you know, actually has nothing to do with the Jason Voorhees character, of course. So I couldn't go this week without paying tribute to my favorite horror icon of all time. This was a tough video to do. I had juggled a couple of ideas, didn't really know what to do. I actually put it out there on Facebook, Instagram, even here on YouTube, what the subject should be. I mean, over the course of 8 years of doing an annual Friday the 13th video, I've covered many subjects, so I was kind of just running out of ideas. And my friend Morbid Maddie actually had the idea that I decided to go with. And he asked me about maybe doing something on Jason's scariest look or like the best mask. But what I wanted to talk about is the unmasking. What is the best look for Jason? What is the best makeup design throughout the course of the entire franchise? Now, of course, I had to omit a few films in the series, ones where either Jason wasn't unmasked or he wasn't in the film at all. So Part 5, A New Beginning, will not be in this list because, of course, that wasn't Jason. That was Roy Burns. Jason Goes to Hell, where Jason's mask was embedded into his skin, so of course you never saw his face. And then Freddy vs. Jason, where you do see like this part of Jason when they lift up his mask and he's spitting up water because Freddy's drowning him in the dreams. But you don't really see his whole face. Eliminated those, but I have 9 films that I'm going to be covering of my favorite looks for Jason Voorhees. So I hope everyone enjoys this. Please stay tuned. So number 9 for me is going to be the look in Jason X. I wasn't really crazy about the way he looked when he was unmasked. Of course, it's the scene where Adrienne is, you know, doing tests on him and she removes the mask from his face. I didn't see a glimpse of Jason's face, and I just thought it was goofy looking. I actually think the sideshow figure of that looked better than it actually did in the movie. I don't know why. It never worked for me. Not that I hate it or anything, but out of all the looks of Jason, it's always been my least favorite. Number 8 for me is going to be his look in the remake. The reason I put this one in there, because I actually, when I've seen the makeup effects work that was done on Derek Mears, and it looked fantastic, but the problem was you never saw it in the movie. You see like 2 really quick glimpses of Jason without his mask, and that's in the scene where he gets his mask torn, the sack head torn off before he kills the guy and takes the hockey mask. And then there's the scene at the end where they kick him back where they push him into Camp Crystal Lake, and then they kick the mask in and you see Jason's face as he slowly sort of sinks to the bottom of the lake. And so my whole thing with this one being low is the execution of it. There should have been a better unmasking. As much as I love the remake, or the reboot, I was always disappointed that you never really got a good look at the makeup design work on Derek Mears, because the behind the scenes images, he looked fantastic. And yeah, I don't know why they did it that way. Number 7 is really not an unmasking scene, but it's the original Friday the 13th from 1980 where Jason jumps out of the lake, and that's of course the makeup effects done by the great Tom Savini. It wasn't unmasking, but I always thought the look of Jason in the original Friday the 13th was very chilling, especially the fact that he is so decayed and covered in dirt and mud and everything when he jumps out and grabs Alice. I always thought that scene was really impactful, and the look of him was just amazing. Number 6 for me will be his look in Part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan. Mm-hmm. Of course, a lot of people don't like this look. The look in this one is it just looks like a melted down version of his looks from Part 3 and Part 7. Renee throws the toxic waste on him, he rips the mask off and he's screaming because it's burning his skin. So you see his face is he does almost have like a Muppet kind of look. A lot of people have compared it to like a Muppet look because it's just a very different look than the previous ones. But I've never had a real problem with it. Again, you know, he was underwater for X amount of years, so I still think the look is pretty cool. Number 5 for me will be his look at the end of Part 2. Of course, this was the one scene where Warrington Gillette played Jason, and that's where he jumps through the window and grabs Jenny. I believe Carl Fullerton did this makeup, and again, this is the one where you have half kind of with the balding head, the balding kind of bumpy, lumpy head, and then the other side is kind of the hillbilly look where it's hair and almost a beard, and he's very creepy looking. That scene I still think is terrifying, where he jumps through that window and just the way he kind of, you know, stretches his arms out to grab Jenny Fields, and I remember that scene scaring me so badly as a kid, and that look of him, and you can just see how much anger and pain Warrington Gillette was in when he had to do that stunt, because I know the first time they did it, it didn't go right, so you see all of that in his expression as he jumps through the window. Still one of my favorite end scenes from the franchise, and still very effective to this day. Number four for me will be part three, his look in part three, of course played by the late, great Richard Brooker. This look, of course, changed over time. Originally, the late, great Stan Winston did the makeup design. There's pictures of how that looked in the Crystal Lake Memories book, but I guess the director didn't, if I remember correctly, the director didn't like it, so they changed it. And I believe Carl Fullerton, who did his makeup in part two, came back uncredited to fix the makeup. He's very creepy in this film, especially when Chris hangs him in the barn, and he reaches up to grab the robe and then pull it off of his head, and he pulls the mask up with it, just the way he looks. And of course it's very different from part two, even though they're supposed to be taking place like in close proximity. This time Jason's completely bald, and there's an expression that Richard Brooker does when the mask is off, and it's almost like a glee on his face at what he's doing. And I really think it's very chilling to watch, and Brooker did a great job as the character, and I still think his unmasking scene, and then the scene where Chris has the dream and he's running after her while she's in the canoe in Crystal Lake, I still think those scenes are some of the best and most chilling in the franchise. Number three for me will be part six, Jason Lives, my favorite Friday the 13th film. And, even though there wasn't really an unmasking in this film, but you see Jason without his mask when they dig him up and open the coffin at the beginning of the film, and just the intimidation of CJ Graham playing this role, and the way that he looked, and with the maggots on his face, and the fact that Jason's been in the grave for X amount of years, I just love that decayed, rotting looking Jason. He's badass when he climbs out of that grave to go after Tommy Jarvis. Just looks amazing. Very quick though, because Jason has the mask on through the rest of the film, but that opening when you see Jason climb out of that grave is still one of my favorite scenes ever in the franchise. Number two for me is going to be the look of Jason in Friday the 13th, The Final Chapter. Of course, this was Tom Savini's swan song of doing Jason's makeup. Ted White, the amazing Ted White, who played, I still think, the scariest version of Jason. The way that Savini looked at it is that, you know, he created the monster with the original, and he kills the monster in The Final Chapter, which was supposed to be the final film in the franchise. And that look of Jason when Trish knocks the mask off at the end, I still think it's just, it's so chilling and so creepy. Just the whole death scene of Tommy hitting him with the machete and him falling and sliding down the machete is just such a great scene. Still gives me chills when I watch it today. And number one should come as no surprise. This is my favorite look for an unmasked Jason, and that is part seven. The new blood, of course, Kane Hodder picking up the reins as the character, and then the late, great John Carl Beekler not only directing but doing the makeup effects. That look for Jason, I don't know how they pulled it off, but that look is so amazing. And the fact that the associate producer of this film didn't want his mask off, you know, so the last 20 minutes of the film, Jason's mask is gone because it cracks in half. That look, that final look of Jason, I still think is so amazing and so well done. That makeup is absolutely fantastic. Hats off, that is the best looking makeup. The fact that it beat Tom Savini's makeup for me is saying a lot, because Tom Savini really put a lot of amazing detail into the likenesses of Jason that he did, but hats off to John Carl Beekler, the late, great John Carl Beekler, for that makeup. That, and Kane Hodder's performance, absolutely fantastic, and still the greatest look for Jason, in my opinion. So that is it, fellow fiends. Another Friday the 13th, another video by the Boogeyman. Yes, the greatest film franchise, in my opinion. Absolutely love it. I will be watching doing my standard watching three random films. I always pick three at random to watch on Friday the 13th. Also, want to give a shout out to my friend Casey. Some of you might know her as the Homicidal Homemaker. She was another person that gave me a great idea for my video. I was going to attempt to make her Camp Crystal cake, and I just didn't have the time to do it, but I will put a link down below to her video. Also, a link to her website, Homicidal Homemaker. She's found great success in doing something really unique and original. I've met her several times. She's an amazing person, a true talent, a true artist. And Casey, maybe in November when the next Friday the 13th rolls around, I will attempt to make your cake. But thank you so much for the suggestions. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for Friday the 13th and these amazing films that I never get tired of watching and I'm so grateful to have. And I hope everyone has a very safe and happy Friday the 13th. And I'll talk to you guys later. Take it easy. Stay scared as always. Peace. Thank everyone for taking this time to drop by the Horror Zone. It really means a lot to me that people are supporting what I do here. If you like this video, please hit the subscribe button down below. I upload videos at least once or twice a week. It would really mean a lot if people would spread the word about this channel. This is a passion of mine. I love the horror genre, and I'm really happy to share my love of it with all of you. So thanks so much again for checking it out, and I'll talk to you guys later. Take it easy.